What is your purpose for trading? This is the question we must all ask ourselves. Are you looking for a quick flip, or do you really want to learn a skill that can be consistent income to supplement or go full time? This will be the biggest factor in your success as a trader, because if money is purely the goal, then it will be damn near impossible to achieve consistency. But if you really have a love for the markets and trading, the money will come naturally. Day trading isn't always the end. It's the means to an end. It's the means to get you to the next level, whether it be investing into big companies, long-term holds, real estate. This is where you can generate capital fairly quickly, but if not done right, you can also lose it very, very quickly as well. So today I want to give you a good outline of how to successfully trade. Here's my strategy to maybe copy or to modify as your own. Now, copying a strategy isn't the best route, since different factors will come into play, like account size difference, experience, and how versed you are with the platform. Try using this outline and modify to your liking. Now, first, I look for accelerated movement in the pre-market trading of stocks, which is usually a precursor to what may happen in the intraday. This requires you to know how to scan in the pre-market, which I have a separate video on the topic. Now, most importantly, very bullish pre-market activity doesn't necessarily mean bullish intraday movement, and vice versa. A stock can overextend too quickly and cause huge sell-offs as people look to take profit from their positions from the previous day. What goes up must come down is what you want to have in mind on these positions. Look for stocks above 15% in gains in the pre-market, but anything past 30% become more sell bias the higher they go, so it's a dangerous game with huge movers. Before you look to buy, you need to identify levels where the stock needs to break before grabbing a position. Breaks of resistance and key levels will cause quick reactions, which we call breakouts. I use the pre-market high and psychological levels, or whole numbers, for my resistance throughout the day, which sometimes can be one and the same. Psychological levels are whole numbers that become resistance if a stock is below the level and support if a stock is above the level. You want to play the breaks of these levels as a breakout. The breaks may run very quick, so you have to have the discipline to let a stock go if it's very far past your potential entry point. It always seems so easy, but now you need rules, because not every breakout or setup will be a good one. Rules are the boundaries for your strategy to work inside. My rules are never long a red day and never short a green day. Keep the sentiment on your side and never play an uphill battle. You need to look at the daily charts combined with intraday charts to see the full picture. Multiple time frames show you much more than being tunnel visioned on the intraday. On the intraday, I set ground rules as well. Never buy the first candle out of the gate. This is my biggest rule. Even if the setup is nice, you need the discipline to sit on your hands, since the first minute of the day is full of previous buyers selling and newer buyers jumping in, which becomes very indecisive. Try sitting on your hands for the first 5 minutes to see trends develop beforehand. You also want to make sure that the stock has an active catalyst. This steers you clear from pump and dumps and schemes. I use the news tab to see the most recent news for the stock. Catalysts I look for are earnings winners, contract wins, FDA trial news or approval, and merger agreements. The goal here is to never anticipate news like earnings and buy beforehand, because you can wake up to a huge loss in your account. Wait for the reaction and never anticipate news, no matter how confident you are. What you put in is what you get out. You can apply this to all aspects of life, but especially in trading. Before you enter any trade, you need to know risk management. One of the first places to manage risk is position sizing. Never go 100% and put all your eggs in one basket. Scale down to 50% or less per position to protect your money from a loss, which no matter how hot you think you are, it will inevitably happen. If you lose 2% on your position, but are only trading with half your account size, then it only means a 1% overall loss to your account. The same is true for your wins. 5% gain on a position is only 2.5% of your account gain, but as a trader, you want repeatable wins to grow, not just a single home run. Something I can't stress enough is always place a stop loss. I probably can title this video, Always Place a Stop Loss, since they have saved me from huge downturns on the even most confident trades. Stop losses instantly liquidate your position once a stock falls below a certain point, which is very helpful in trades where you might move your eyes away from the screen and potentially take a nice loss if the stock starts to dump. Also, if you snag a big runner and you can move up the stop loss higher to ultimately give yourself a best case scenario where you always win. The sequence should be set your stop loss for 2.5% loss. Then as a stock reaches higher levels, you can put the stop loss at your entry price, ultimately making it impossible to lose. And then higher the stock goes, the higher you move your stop. Now, always remember, never move your stop lower. Either keep it where it was placed or move it higher. Now, putting it all together, let me show you how to trade the full process. So, PRVB, this is a stock that I was playing around in June. Very, very crazy pre-market activity. So the stock was very, very volatile to the top side. Seeing how high it was, I know it was a very, very risky play out of the gate. So especially looking out of the gate, seeing all those red candles really kind of steered me away from it. But now I'm looking for the pre-market high. That usually is going to be my indication that I want to play a break. I like to look for the actual breaks above. So usually when the stocks actually break above the points, that's usually when I'm going to be looking to jump in, because I find that they're a little bit more solid rather than anticipating and hitting some resistance. So at that point, I set my limit order right above, and it instantly goes through. So if you set limit orders above sometimes the price, you're going to instantly execute. If you set them below, you have to wait for the stock to come down to actually touch your order. Now with this stock here, I set my stop loss at around 3%. So usually with that, and you can see quickly right afterwards, the stock is running with a lot of force. So I'm moving up that stop loss with a lot of different increments as I go up. Usually the first place I want to move it to is my entry price, and then higher and higher as levels are met. So it's never just going to be a straight follow through most of the time. Sometimes you're gonna have stocks that wanna ebb and flow, where you have to keep your risk very, very managed and not move your stop losses down. But in this situation, you may snag a very, very quick runner like this, where it continues to wanna go up higher and higher. And I'm just moving my stop loss up every, maybe every 10% that the stock goes up, I'm moving my stop losses up a little bit higher. There's no exact science, but that's pretty much how it goes. Now, the stock got halted there, so you saw that it slowed down in price action. Stocks move too quick, they're going to get halted by the SEC. That's just really how it goes. Now, after a certain point, I didn't wait for the stock to hit my stop loss. I actually just sold while I was ahead. And that's one thing that I always like to teach too, especially with my students, is especially if you're so far past your initial sell target, you don't have to wait for the stock to pull back to hit your stop loss. Might as well exit at that point. Now, hindsight is always 20/20. So at the end of the day, let's say for the next 20 or 30 minutes, the stock continues to run, go farther and further. Should you change your strategy where you aim for more? Not necessarily. Or at the end of the day, I mean, I like having a lot of room for error. So if after I exit a stock and it continues to run for 10, 20, 30 minutes, or actually 10, 20, 30%, I know that I picked the good stock and I picked the good entry, because even if I would have aimed for a little bit more just with my emotional inconsistencies, I still would have exited for a profit. So if you ever find that you're exiting right at the tip top, the raggedy edge, that means you're being a little bit too more aggressive with your approach, where you want to kind of pull back a little bit. But all in all, this is really how a majority of my strategies go and my trades go. Now, I will take losses here and there, but especially with the losses, I'm usually cutting them at my stop loss. So if you're able to cut, let's say 2.5% in loss per each trade, and every single time you gain, you're looking to gain 5% or more, you're gonna constantly stair step your way up. And especially if the stock really wants to run past your target, you can let it go, move your stop losses up, and really make those wins stretch a little bit further. But that's really it. Hopefully you guys like this format. I have an editor now that I got on payroll. So at the end of the day, we're gonna be shooting out some good quality videos. I'm like quality over quantity now. So with that said, I thank you guys for letting us break through 50,000 subscribers. I never thought it would get to that point. It's ridiculous, because I only have like 11 videos now. So shout out to you guys. You guys are amazing. If you guys like the content, you want me to do more like this, hit the subscribe, hit the like button, send a comment down below. You guys need help, just let me know. So you can always look at the website. I have a lot of programs that I offer, especially with personal one-on-one mentorship. So especially if you guys are interested in that, let me know. Outside of that, you guys want that free education? Here you go. So hope you guys enjoyed. Eat, sleep, profit for the win. Boom.